please just remember when you come to the stand, please.
Pinball is what I'm after, or Stargazer. just something a bit odd. I like the latest, some of the last ones, because they're quite unusual, even Orbit of One. Which is like a really bizarre game in a way. Something different.
Yeah.
Just simply because there's, you know, they're unusual to me, and there's not many of them about.
Yeah.
You know, that's an added attraction to me, I find.
Okay, right. Well, I hope someone watching this video has got one of your favourite machines.
Okay,
thank you very much. Right.
Thank you. Quite often the most inexpensive, because they're basically wooden, and nails, they don't break very easy. There's quite a lot around. That would, you know, they will start selling around about 15, 20, 25 quid.
Yeah.
It tends to be the more complicated metal or plastic or, you know, where you get a more complex mechanism where they break very easily.
Yeah.
Or things that have been imported, like the American one, when they can reach sort of hundreds. And depending on what condition they're in and how attractive they are, yeah, all sorts of prices.
Okay, thanks a lot then.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Six and a half years ago, and I had a new thing.
I do play a good bit of tennis.
What special features has the game got that makes it so unusual?
Basically, it's very rewarding in terms of skill shots. One thing I really like about it is the way you can protect the ball from actually going out and play. Features on the playing field. Before you actually, one thing it sets it apart from other machines. It's very fast as well. I like fast machines.
Would you ever sell it, Jeremy?
The funny thing is, I've just actually had an offer for it. But I'm looking at all solid at the minute.
Right. The other machine you've got here today is a Bally Wizard, which is just behind us now. I believe that's got a special story to it as well.
Yeah, the Wizard was based on the Tommy film. And so it features Roger Daltrey and Anne Margaret on the back of that. And the game itself was very popular and a big seller for Bally. I sold over 10,000 machines, which is the first time that ever happened. Although it's sold 10,000, it's quite hard to actually find one, certainly find one in good condition, because it was a very popular machine. That's quite fortunate to get that example.
Right. Have you got any other machines in your collection, Jerry?
We've got a producer, Spectrum, my apart, but this man. He's not working at the minute. And I've got a machine which I've been constructing for the last 5 or 6 years myself. Hopefully it might be finished in the next few years.
I think we've seen that machine down at the convention before.
Yeah.
Tell us its latest state of completion, Jerry.
It's actually probably about getting near to 90% complete now. I'm just finishing off the software for it. I expect to have something sort of operational by about June this year.
So we can hope to see it at the next convention?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, Jerry, thank you very much.
You do.
Thank you. I'm going to go to the next one. Brass rod and stuff like that. The only trouble is obviously the sold them all the time.
My father started me, and he gave me this machine and four others.
Yeah.
He told me to sell them for a jumble sale, and I couldn't part with them, so I've started from there onwards.
Yeah.
And I've been able and lucky enough to collect them all over the country.
Yeah. So why are you actually interested in these games?
Oh, I like them perhaps because of my age.
Yeah.
I can remember them as a boy,
yeah.
And from then onwards I just like them. They are.
Okay. All right, tell us a little bit about this one then.
Only that it's 1928, I think. It's been told it's 1928. And it's an original.
Yeah.
It is an all-wind deluxe, which is an original all-wind deluxe.
Okay. What sort of condition was it in when you had it?
Workable condition.
Yeah.
I haven't had a lot to do with it except clean it and polish it. But other machines, like this one,
yeah.
When I got that machine, it was in a barn under some straw,
yeah.
And the gun was off and broken.
Yeah.
And I rebuilt the gun with some help of a friend who's here now.
Yeah.
And when we stripped it down, we found it was green underneath, so we returned it to its original.
All right, that's good.
That one didn't cost me a lot of money, but it's worth a lot now.
And you can reveal how much?
I've been told it's worth £1,500.
Really? £1,500?
Yeah.
And you found it in a barn?
I found it in a barn. But then again, sometimes you're lucky and some you're not.
Yeah.
This was with it as well, but that was in a terrible state when I got it. Terrible.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Morrison.
I went to a place called Mesh.
Paul and Colin, most of us have come from all over England here. Where have you come from?
From Holland. We come from Den Bosch.
Yeah? What time did you get here?
We got here yesterday.
Yeah?
And Bob and Mandy picked up us from Kedwick.
Yeah? Right. Must be fairly interesting people to come all this way then.
Yeah. Very much pinball enthusiastic, so...
Yeah, all right. What's this scene like in Holland? Are there many games there?
Yeah. It's very much alive, the pinball scene there in Holland.
All right. So what's your favourite one here then?
The new ones, Mousing Around and Robocop. But more Mousing Around.
Yeah. How did you do in the competition?
I dropped out in the second round by John Wyatt there.
Okay. Oh well, enjoy yourself.
Yeah, very much.
Okay, well,
very nice.
Yeah, glad you came all this way.
Yeah.
All right, okay.
Hope to see you next year.
Yeah.
Day actually, Simon. This morning we had BBC round and we had a little interview with them, which was good fun.
Yeah.
And most of the rest of the day has been spent on the stand, making lots of money, selling all the raffle tickets, and pushing the voting for the best machines here for the whole.
So what sort of things have you been selling?
Well, usual sort of merchandise that we advertise in the magazine. There's pinball books, the jukebox books, stickers, badges, all sorts of things like that.
Have you got spare parts for the machine?
Yeah, they've been going really well today as well. Yeah. It's been good. And new lines that we've started up, pay field cleaner.
Yeah.
Been going really well.
Yeah. What about new members? Potential new members?
Honestly, don't know. I saw one new member join today.
Yeah.
But no, I haven't had much involvement with that today.
So the sales have been pretty good then?
Very good, yeah. And really pleased with it.
All the contributions go to the club?
Back into the club, yeah.
Yeah.
Really good. And also, we've been very, very lucky with Associated Leisure giving us this pin table for the raffle prize,
which
we'll be drawing very soon.
Yeah.
So that helps boost the club funds, no end. Really good.
Okay, jolly good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Later on. Yeah, I found it.
Nice.
We should really give Barbara, our organiser, a big round of applause because she's done a terrific job. Thanks, Bob.
Okay, thanks.
Right, now, first of all, I think we'll have the awards for the best machines on display here today. And we'll start with best electronic. We're the owner of the Cosmic Gunfight. Machine number 3, please come forward for best electronic.
Co-owners,
we don't mind. Will you collect your trophy from Barbara, please? We have the best electronics with a Cosmic Gunfight.
Sorry.
Well done. Okay, next machine is for best electromechanical, and with a good vote was the Wizard. So can we have the owner of the Wizard for best electromechanical? Well done. Good on, Joe. Okay, next award goes to the best slot machine here today, and it's the Nova Mat. Nova Mat. With the owner of the Nova Mat, please come forward.
Hi.
For best slot machine. Well done, John. And we couldn't really think of a final category for this, so we just put down best other, but because it covered a variety of machines, it could have been anything. But the winner of the best other section is a lovely little machine, which I have unfortunately mucked up, but I think it's okay now. It's the Bally Airway. The Bally Airway. Well done, John. Lovely little machine, that. Right, now we come on to our competition winners. And we have the winner for the Junior Wizard is Sarah Connett. Well done, Sarah. And as most of you know, the winner of this year's Pinball Wizard Shield is John Wyatt. First of all, I must say, runner-up, Dave Kingston, well done. Very well done. John Wyatt, this year's winner. For those of you who didn't actually see the competition, John's score was 1,880,180, and Dave was 1,092,820. So well done, John, and well done, Dave, for getting into the finals. Okay, well, that's it, really. I mean, if you want to hang around and have a flip for a while, you're welcome to. Thanks again, everyone, for coming. Thanks especially to Barbara for doing all the hard work, and thanks also to the committee for putting in their 5 minutes work. Good amazing. Okay, I'll shut up now, and then you can all get back on the machine.